Hey, how's it going? This is Eduard Stenga from VideoPlasty and welcome to this tutorial where I'm going to show you how to create professional video animations or explainer videos in an amazing piece of software that is free called HitFilm Express. You don't need any previous animation experience or graphic design skills. You just need this software and some really basic editing skills, which you can actually pick up by just watching this video. So without further ado, let's have a quick look at the sample video that I created. It's for a fake company that doesn't exist. And this is the video that we're gonna recreate today. And you're gonna be able to create something like this immediately after watching this tutorial. So let's make this full screen and have a look.
So you're sick and tired of the same routine, same job you don't really like that much. But then it hits you. What if you take a break from all that boring stuff and go on an adventure? Like, pack your stuff right now and get ready to leave as soon as possible. Welcome to YourDreamTrips.com, the best travel agency in your local area. With us, it's all really simple. It doesn't matter if you want to go to an exotic island, go camping, sail around the sea, or go from place to place on a world tour. We got you covered. Don't forget your camera, because once you're on that airplane traveling halfway across the world, you'll want to take a picture of the clouds from your window seat. The view from 10,000 feet is amazing. Or take a selfie when you get there and post it on social media. Or really, just sit on the beach, enjoying the sun and relaxing. That's why you're there, aren't you? So give us a call at 1-234-5678 and book your dream holiday today.
All right. I think that looks pretty amazing. And I know what you're thinking right now. This looks way too complicated and you might feel a bit overwhelmed. And I understand that because that's how animation looks from the outside. But by using the method that I'm going to show you in this tutorial, this is going to seem actually super simple for you to do. And the way we're going to do this today is by using something not many people know, something called stock animation. And if you haven't heard about stock animation before, it's pretty much like stock footage or, stock photos, but for animation. So it's basically like a library of pre-animated assets that you can just drag and drop on the timeline and arrange them in the right order and you're good to go. Because that's the whole point. They come pre-animated and ready to go and you don't need to do basically anything else. So there are many places online where you can get a stock animation. We're going to get to that in a minute. Actually, I'm just going to leave that for the end of the tutorial. First, let's have a look and see how you can use them. I already selected a couple of files that we're going to use for this tutorial. And I'm just going to go ahead and import them into HitFilm Express. All right. So as you can see, we already have them here imported. First things first, whenever you make any sort of video, you want to start with a script, but that's a topic for like a whole different video. So for this video, we already have a script and a voiceover recorded. I'm not going to show you how you can do that here. That's not the purpose of this tutorial. So I'm just going to go ahead and first thing you want to do is you want to import the voiceover on the timeline. Because the voiceover is basically the foundation of the video, like what message you send across and how you want to time the entire animation, you want to follow this waveform here on the bottom. And another cool thing you want to have is you want to have some music on the track. So I'm just going to drag and drop this here. Actually, no. I think I have to insert, audio too. So you insert a new audio track by right-clicking here and insert track. And that's when you drag and drop this here. All right, this one is a bit longer, so I'm just gonna zoom out and drag it here to make it shorter. All right, when you have a voiceover like this and music, what you wanna do is you wanna make the music a bit more, like not so loud basically. And you want to play around with a couple of like different options for the volume. And the way you do that in HitFilm Express is you have this line here. So you're just going to drag it up. By default, it's on 0. And I'm just going to drag it to minus like 24. Let's see how it sounds.
So you're sick and tired of the same routine. Same.
Yeah, I think that's pretty good. You can hear the voiceover very, very clearly. So, all right. As you can see here on the left in the media tab, we have all those cool animations already imported with the character. And as I was telling you earlier, they're pre-animated. All you have to do is drag and drop them on the timeline, which is exactly what we're going to do here. And here, as you can see on the voiceover, the first line here, according to the waveform, is...
So, you're sick and tired of the same routine.
And the sentence ends here, basically. So, I'm just going to drag and drop this clip called Tired. Going to drag it here, align it to the beginning. And here, towards the end, I'm just going to make it shorter because... When this next sentence comes, I wanna use a different clip. And let's see what the next sentence is.
Same job you don't really like that much. But...
All right, so the next one is same job you don't really like that much. For that one, let's see, I used this one, sleeping at work. Oops, where it is? There you go. All right, drag and drop it here. Just gonna move this a bit lower. All right, make this one shorter too. All right, one thing we gotta do now, as you can see, the background is transparent because those stock animation assets come with a transparent background, so you can use like any sort of image or like just a static color if you want. For this particular project, we're just gonna use a static background with a color. And let's see, the way we do that in HitFilm Express is click here on New Plane. I'm just going to call it Background. And for the color, let's see what we're going to use here. Obviously, you know, play around with it. You're not going to get it right from the first time, so I'm just going to try a couple of things maybe. Yeah, this should work. Let's hit OK. Hit OK here as well, and then we have background. So now you want to drag and drop the background here on the timeline. However, you want to have the background on the first layer under those stock animation assets. So we're gonna right click here and insert a new track for the videos. All right, so I'm gonna select both videos and I'm gonna move them up, and then I'm gonna drag the background right below them. All right, already looks much better. However, it's not exactly the best color. So I'm just gonna right click on this, go to properties, and just adjust the color slightly. I move it a bit towards there, click OK, click OK. Still not happy. All right, that looks better, and it's very, very similar to the color we have in the tutorial video, in the sample video, basically. All right, so let's have a quick look from the beginning and see how it looks. We have like the first 5-6 seconds of the video or something like that. Just gonna drag this here and play.
So you're sick and tired of the same routine, same job you don't really like that much, but then it hits you.
All right, I think that looks pretty good. The reason why the video is blurred is because here in the playback resolution, we have quarter during playback, so it doesn't use that much of the system resources. And I'm also recording this video, so it's probably not a good idea to put the quality on full. But it should be good enough to figure out what we're doing here. All right, so let's see what the next line in the voiceover says.
But then it hits you. What if...
So this small part here in the waveform is, but then it hits you. So for that one, I just use, I've started with this one actually, with thinking. I'm just going to put it here. Zoom out a little bit. All right. Make this super short, like here. Oh, and we have to make the background longer. I forgot to do that. All right, so, but then it hits you. So it's like the guy thinking. And then he gets an idea. So I'm just going to drag and drop the idea.
What if you take a... But then it hits you. What if you take a break from all that boring stuff?
All right, what if you take a break from all that boring stuff? The next line in the voiceover says, and go on an adventure or something like that. Basically, what you have to do is you have to keep playing around with the timings. Like, a guideline is obviously follow what the voiceover is saying, but you will have to play it back a couple of times and see if it works well. So the next one is traveling, I think. Yeah, this one. It's called traveling. Again, drag and drop it here. Let's play it back and see where we have to stop it.
And go on an adventure. Like, pack your...
Again, I'm going to make it shorter because the next part in the voiceover says, like, pack your stuff right now and get ready to leave as soon as possible, I think. So for that one, I selected something different than what we used previously. As you saw before, we had stock animation with transparent background. They can just like move around, scale it, and whatever. So for the next scene, I use a full screen scene, which you can actually preview here, for example. So I'm just going to use this scene with someone packing his luggage before going on a trip. And, you know, drag and drop it here, as always. Let's move the selection here.
Pack your stuff right now and get ready to leave as soon as possible.
All right. Again, you know, make this one shorter. Let's see what the next part in the voiceover says.
Welcome to yourdreamtrips.com.
All right, so the next part in the voiceover is welcome to yourdreamtrips.com. And at this point is like the point where you introduce the company with the logo and like the name of the company or website underneath it. And let's see how we can do that in HitFilm Express. For the logo, because we don't have one, I just use this animation of the van. I'm just going to drag and drop it here. You're going to have to resize it, but we're going to do that a bit later. So let's add some text. And the way you add text in HitFilm Express is a bit different. If you want to learn more about that, I might create a tutorial next. But I'm just going to quickly go over it. You have to hit new and do composite shot. So I'm just going to say this. I'm going to call this one title 1. Let's make it, I don't know, 6 seconds long, basically. Let's make it 5 seconds long, actually. All right, and now we kind of switch the view between editor to title 1. It's like a different thing. And here in title 1, I'm going to create a new layer and I'm going to call it text. And select the text tool and just say yourdreamtrips.com. And yeah, the way you change this, you're going to have to highlight the entire text now. And here on the left where it says history text, just select text. And I'm going to change the font to something else like Open Sans. I'm going to make it slightly bigger. Maybe make it bold as well. Let's see. Regular. Actually make it bold. And also because of the background we have in the video, I'm just going to change the color from white to black. Okay. Good. You can't really see much here, but we're going to go back to the editor. And now if you go to media, we have this thing called title. So we want to add the title on top of the van. So I'm just going to right click here and insert another video track. All right. And now let's just drag and drop the title. And the timing is going to match with the timing of the logo, basically. We have this thing right here on the bottom. We don't need it. So I'm just going to right click and unlink. Because this way I can select the audio separately. In our case, it's just like empty audio. There's no actual audio in it. So now we need to play around with it a bit and do some resizing. So with a select tool here, just grab one of the corners and hold shift while you do it. And this way you can preserve the ratio because you don't want to resize it like this. All right, so I'm just going to resize it a bit like this. Move it up. Oops. Move this actually a bit lower. And for the van, move it on top. And there you go. Looks pretty, pretty good. But right now the text doesn't have any animation. So I'm just going to do a quick one, like super simple. So let's select the text again. I'm going to try to get it to match the way the van logo animates in and out. So I'm just going to do that real quick here in controls. And you want to have this thing on. You want to have this on. It's the display timeline for the keyframes. Keyframing is a whole different tutorial. If you want, again, just let me know in the comments and I'll make a tutorial just on that. But for now, I'm just going to quickly do it so you can, you know, see how easy it is. So I'm just going to play with the scale and the opacity. I'm going to put two keyframes there. And at the beginning here, I'm going to put opacity to 0% and the scale to 50. And then I'm going to do the same at the end. Let's see. Actually here all the way to the end, I'm going to do the scale again to 50 and the opacity to 0%. And I want it to start somewhere around here. So another keyframe here and another keyframe here. I think that should be pretty good. We have, let's see, the first 20 seconds of the video is already done. Let's have a look from the beginning and see how the entire thing looks.
So you're sick and tired of the same routine, same job you don't really like that much. But then it hits you. What if you take a break from all that boring stuff and go on an adventure? Like pack your stuff right now and get ready to leave as soon as possible. Welcome to yourdreamtrips.com, the best travel agency in your local area.
All right, I think that looks pretty amazing. We already have the first 20 seconds of the video done, and it literally took us less than 10 minutes to do this whole thing. And as you saw, most of it was just literally, you know, finding a good stock animation clip here that you selected previously, drag and drop it on the timeline, and just time it with the voiceover, and then pretty much repeat the entire process for the whole voiceover, like the entire project. I'm not gonna continue with the rest of the video up until like the 1 minute mark, because it's just gonna get boring and I don't wanna drag this on forever. It's pretty much doing the exact same thing as I did before. I'm sure you already figured out how to do it by just watching me recreate those first 20 seconds. And it's pretty simple and I'm sure you can do it as well right now. All right, so now the big question is, where can you find stock animation for your projects? And you can have a quick look online, do a search for stock animation, check out some of the big stock footage sites. My problem with that, however, is that all the stock animation that I could find wasn't really of high quality. And it was all coming from like different vendors here and there with like small pieces here and there. And the problem was that if you wanted to make a video out of those, it was very inconsistent. So that's actually the main reason why I created a website called VideoPlasty.com. So full disclosure, yes, I own VideoPlasty, but I made it to have like this marketplace where we sell exclusively just stock animation. It's all created in-house and all the assets are very similar to one another. So like the style of the animation and the graphic design style is very consistent. So you can pick from like any of the packs that we have and mix and match them together. And the video is going to work super well. So have a look on the website. It's called, again, videoplasty.com. We have all sorts of like character packs, animated icons, scenes, and other stuff. And, you know, have a look. Let me know what you think. I would be super excited to see what videos you guys make using the stock animation from VideoPlasty. So be sure to send me a couple of videos. I'll be really happy to watch them. Alright, this is the end of the tutorial. This was Edward Stinger from VideoPlasty. I hope you enjoyed it and I'll see you soon.